Hello dear students, in the last video I asked you to balance this equation BaCl2 plus Na2SO4 that gives BSO4 and NaCl. I hope you might have tried. If not, I am going to solve it for you. In this particular equation, we have BaLHS1 RHS1, ClLHS2 RHS2, NaLHS2 RHS1, ClLHS2 RHS1, NaLHS2 RHS1, sulfur LHS1 RHS1, oxygen LHS4 RHS4. So we just need to balance this chlorine and sodium, and we already have a right hand side NaCl. So first we just need to multiply it with 2. So finally we get this equation: BaCl2 aqueous plus Na2SO4 aqueous plus BaSO4 solid plus 2 NaCl aqueous. And this is how we can find all the atoms have been easily become equal, like barium 1-1, chlorine 2-2, Na sodium 2-2, sulfur 1-1, oxygen 4-4. All elements are equal both the sides, and we can say that equation is balanced. Now we need to understand about the physical state. In class 10th we are going to study three physical states: solid state, which is also known as precipitate, we have seen it. Or we can say it is an insoluble substance, which is represented by bracket S. Then we can show the liquid state, which is represented by bracket L. We can show the gaseous state, which is represented by bracket G. We can show the solution in water or aqueous solution, which can be written as in bracket AQ. These all symbols are written into the parenthesis. Sodium hydroxide solution in water. Next question. Sodium hydroxide solution in water reacts with hydrochloric acid solution in water to produce sodium chloride solution and water. Here we can see that sodium chloride solution in water, that is NaCl aqueous, hydrochloric acid solution in water, that is HCl aqueous, sodium hydroxide solution in water, that is NaOH aqueous, and water, that is water, it is in liquid state, so it is H2O liquid. So we can write the skeletal equation: NaOH aqueous plus HCl aqueous, that gives NaCl aqueous plus H2O liquid. We can see here the number of atoms.